win for the Hillers. Scoreless between the ninth-seeded Hillers and the sixth-seeded Notre Dame of Hingham Cougars. Tom Nappy, Mike Terosian on the call. Hasbrook on the entry. Mike also running camera on this beautiful afternoon. Here comes the Hillers, an opportunity here. Shot to the left, and that's in! Goal, Hopkinton, Allie Bird! It comes with 14:54 left to go in the first half. And the Hillers, they have the lead. Allie Bird strikes again. She had the only goal in the win against Medway, and she gets one here.
On Monday, November 12th, another great defensive effort by the Hillers girls soccer team led to a sectional finals victory over Notre Dame of Hingham by a final of 1-0. The Hillers are 4-0 in the postseason and have outscored their opponents 5-0 in the playoffs. That's right, the Hillers have not allowed a goal all throughout the postseason. Out of 22 games the Hillers have played this season, they shut out their opponents in 17 of them and have allowed only 7 goals all season long. The last goal the Hillers let up was all the way back on October 15th. Truly amazing defense. Head coach Wayne Sigrove is in his first season at the helm for the Hillers and is excited about advancing to the state finals.
So first off, a big day for a couple of your players today. You had Natalie Hawkins, Gabby Welding signing the letters of intent. Can you talk about what it's been like to coach those two?
Yeah, it's been fantastic. Two senior, two captains. Natalie's been our goalkeeper, outstanding. She was just voted our unsung hero of the year. Only conceded 7 goals all season, 0 goals in the tournament. She's been a rock back there for us. Really happy that she's carrying on her athletic career at Merrimack College, great school. Although she's not playing soccer, she's going to be playing lacrosse. She's got a bright future ahead of her. And same for Gabby, she's been outstanding. Voted a TVL All-Star, great leader, scored some vital goals for the girls. And she's moving on to UMass Lowell to carry on her soccer career. So they have a bright future ahead of them.
Coach, and this is your first year coaching girls soccer, but the team just seems to get better every single game. And they've pitched shutouts throughout the postseason. What's it been like to coach this group?
It's been fantastic. It's been a great ride. We obviously new season, so a few bumps in the road early on, getting to know the girls, new system, new environment, new culture, new mentality, but the girls have really bought into the process. They've got better each and every game as the season's gone along. They've grown in confidence. They believe in each other. And to win their first tournament final, my first season is fantastic, and hopefully we can finish off and win the state finals this Saturday.
And how excited is the team to be heading to the state finals?
Oh, they're pumped. We had our banquet on Monday after the tournament final, and they're so excited. It's been an awesome season, and they just can't wait to get going on Saturday.
All right, Coach. Well, congratulations. We wish you the best of luck Saturday.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Due to a snowstorm that hit before the scheduled Saturday state championship game, Hopkinton and Winchester met up in the Division II state championship on Sunday, November 18th at Marshfield High School. It was a great defensive battle throughout. Riley Delaney defending in front of the net, and the ball ends up grazing her arm, and in soccer, that is a penalty. In the 59th minute of the game, senior midfielder Grace Casey nets a goal on a penalty kick for Winchester, and that would be all they needed. The game would end by a final of 1-0. The Hiller girls fall in the state championship and end a tremendous season with a record of 13 wins, 4 losses, and 6 ties. Congratulations to head coach Wayne Sigrove and the Lady Hillers on a tremendous season and achieving the deepest playoff run for girls soccer in Hopkinton High School history.